Welcome! Gonna show you some 1990s pre-recorded mini discs that I've picked up this week today. I wasn't going to just yet, I was gonna wait and see even if it took weeks or even months, as I do these mini disc collection updates quite sporadically. I was gonna wait and add a few more to the collection because I do look for cheap mini discs in particular on eBay and Discogs now and again. And I've made a few purchases that all came earlier this week, and I've been set up to filming today, and just the post this week has been really slow. There's stuff that has been out there for a week now and it's still not arrived, and I'm off on holiday for a few days in a couple of days. In fact, I will probably either be on holiday or I'll have come back by the time this video goes out. I wanted to get something filmed in case there was a little bit of a lull in content during me. I'm only away for like 3 days, but you know me, I like to keep pumping stuff out. So, right, two purchases from Discogs, one from eBay, all very impulsive, but all do fit my mini disc collection overall, because I've got, particularly with the first two that I'm going to show you, I've got previous mini disc albums by these artists. None of them particularly very cool, but we'll talk about them and I'll show them you anyway. Right, first one, this was from Discogs Marketplace and it was just $9.99. That's a good price for an MD, I always find, as any collector will tell you. Some mini discs on the aftermarket, I mean, it's been an aftermarket now for, you know, 20 years nearly, but some are just so overpriced, and I've paid high-end for certain ones in my collection. But this one was nice and cheap. Ricky Martin with his self-titled 1999 album, Ricky Martin. Now, this is actually my third Ricky Martin album in my collection, all of them on MD. This one, I think, is probably his most successful in much of the world. I mean, he's a Puerto Rican guy, so, I mean, he was having Spanish language album releases, and I've got one of them on MD before his kind of English language breakthrough in 1998-1999 with Living La Vida Loca, which is one of the tracks on here. In fact, that track features twice. There's the English version, although it's still got bits of Spanish in it because the name's Living La Vida Loca, and it's got the Spanish, or it might be classed as Spanglish, version further on down as well. I say this every time I get a Ricky Martin mini disc. And I was watching a couple of my old mini disc update videos back last night after I'd listened to this, just to see what I'd said about previous Ricky Martin albums. You know what? I quite like him. It's a real sort of embarrassingly guilty pleasure. And he doesn't really do anything nowadays, I don't think. Nothing that ever comes across my radar. But there's some singles that I know and I like on here. I think my favourite one that I was already familiar with on here was Private Emotion. Great ballad, that. There's another good ballad as well. I'll play a little bit of it, hopefully, if the copyright Gestapo don't stop me from doing so. She's All I Ever Had. And interesting, I didn't realise this, there's a duet with Madonna on here as well that's called, if I can read it, my sight's really bad at the moment, and the ring light doesn't help, Be Careful, and then there's something in Spanish in brackets. So yeah, there's Madonna on here, and I think that track was written and co-produced with William Orbit as well, who was a well-known, respected producer. I got a William Orbit mini-disc in my last mini-disc update video, so check that out in the music collecting playlist. But you know what? $9.99, and then a little bit in postage, but I got something else from the same seller. I'm not going to complain at all, really. Pretty good album if you're into Latin pop, sort of late 90s dance pop. Living La Vida Loca, it got overplayed at the time, we all know that, and it still sort of sounds way too familiar even 22 years on, but there we are, Ricky Martin and Ricky Martin. Next one from the same Discogs Marketplace seller. This one was more expensive. In fact, it was twice as expensive. Whereas Ricky Martin was $9.99. Celine Dion's Let's Talk About Love was $19.99. And then together, there was, I don't know, £3-ish in postage. So this is my second Celine Dion album in my collection. I've also got Falling Into You, which came out originally, I think it was 96, on MD. This one was released a year or so later in 97. And there again, I'm mainly familiar with stuff on here, thanks to the fact that my mother had this album. I'm not a Celine Dion fan, but I am a fan of collecting Minidisc. And while £20, that's the sort of price I like to pay for a mini disc that I really want. This one, I don't know, I kind of just got it on a whim because I was ordering Ricky Martin. I realised that I could get another one and the seller wouldn't charge me any more in postage. But obviously it's still another £20 to add to the order. And some of the other mini discs that he had in his sale listings on Discogs didn't interest me. It was stuff that I'd never heard of particularly, or stuff that was really quite overpriced, sort of around the £30-40 mark. So I thought this one, yeah, I'll get it, because there's enough on here that I do actually like, believe it or not. The second track, Immortality, that features the Bee Gees, and I think it was written or co-written with them as well. I quite like that. Treat Her Like a Lady, the version on here, and I listened to this last night as well, right after Ricky Martin. The version on here, which was originally a Diana King hit, and she features as a backing vocalist with Brownstone on Celine's version. It's a bit of a novelty, gimmicky song, really, because Celine Dion is trying to do sort of reggae dancehall, and she can't really pull it off. But I did used to have that CD single back in the day. I got it cheap somewhere, and there's a brilliant remix of it. Absolutely fantastic. Much better than the album version. And, you know, obviously I knew that wouldn't be on here. It'd be the normal reggae version. But it's all right for a laugh. My Heart Will Go On is on here. I've got that on the Titanic soundtrack, which, again, I showed in a mini disc update. Probably the last one that I did. The final track is the title track. And I do quite like that. Let's Talk About Love. I don't think that came out as a single, but I'm quite fond of that. But there's a lot of ballads and stuff on here that I'm not overly keen on. Some bad news for Jason Clough. There is a duet with Barbara Streisand, Not Suitable for Mum's Favourite Person in the World, on here, Tell Him. That came out as a single. I think it reached the top 10 in the UK and probably other parts of the world. And there's quite a lot of singles released off here, I think. So yeah, £20, I have overpaid for this because I don't like it £20 worth, certainly. But it's another one for the collection. £20, not an absolute fortune. Great condition, by the way, this. Excellent condition, I would say. Not really an awful lot to look at when I get a mini disc out of its case. Nice glossy booklet in there as well with credits and things and high quality photos. Celine Dion with Let's Talk About Love. It's totally uncool, unfashionable, but I'm an MD collector and I just thought, why not? Final album to show you is one that I won in an auction on eBay. First eBay auction, or even eBay purchase for a mini disc that I've made in quite some time. I used to look on eBay for mini discs so often, but with me collecting other things, vinyl records, Funko Pops, yada yada yada, I don't tend to look as often as I used to, say 2-3 years ago. But I just fancied having a look for some mini discs, and there was a couple I missed out on because people were outbidding one another and I didn't want to go too high. This one I'm pretty pleased with. It does fit my collection. The price, £24. I think that was with free postage. I think I was willing to go up to 25 for this because I do know there's some singles on here that I like. And I'm talking about Melanie C of the Spice Girls fame with her debut album from 1999, Northern Star. I've not listened to this in full yet. I just put it on briefly earlier today just to record a little clip to add on into this video, but I'll give this a listen probably this evening, I think. But I'm familiar with the singles on here. Northern Star, the title track, love that song, really nice sort of mid-tempo pop song. Never Be the Same Again, that features Lisa Left Eye Lopez from TLC. I Turn to You, I think that's quite a different version from the I Turn to You single remix that hit number one back in, that would have been 2000, I think. That one was remixed by somebody, this one will be the proper album version, but I think I've heard the normal album version and quite like it. I think there are three main singles on here. I think Going Down, track three, was a single as well, but I can't remember that. That's not ringing any bells, but like I say, I will give this a full listen later on. I have collected Spice Girls on Minidisc, and as far as the solo stuff's concerned, I've also got Jerry Halliwell's debut album, Schizophonic, which is alright in places. The familiar singles are ranging from kind of ropey to good. I think this one overall is probably going to be a more quality album, a decent pop album overall, because I think Melanie C generally was a better solo artist for my money than Jerry Halliwell anyway. So I'm quite looking forward to listening to this. And there again, ideally I wouldn't have paid more than 20 for it, but I thought, well, maybe it was because I've missed out on a few auctions and things, and I thought, oh, I just want to get a mini disc on eBay, so I'll bid a little bit over what I'm comfortable with. And 24, yeah, fine. Conditions, got a crack across, but anyone who knows Minidisc knows that the cases are pretty rubbish, really. It's not broken off its hinges like a lot of my Minidisc cases have. It's just got that crack in the front, and the disc itself, these are always in excellent condition and always play perfectly fine. So looking forward to giving this a proper listen later on. Melanie C into my kind of Spice Girls collection, although it's a solo album, but in my Discogs collection database, I'll categorise it under Spice Girls, certainly. This is Northern Star. And there we are, that's three mini discs that I bought and received a few days ago. Like I said, I wasn't going to do this video quite yet. I would have liked another one or two mini discs to show you, but I'm waiting for so much in the post, not MDs, I'm just waiting for other things that I want to unbox and talk about on the channel. And it's been a bit of a frustrating week for the posters. I'm expecting a fair bit of stuff and most of it's not come. And I'm away for a few days this weekend, so obviously I'm not going to be around to do any filming if anything comes in my absence. But thank you all for watching this. I hope you enjoyed it. Special thanks go, as they always do, to my wonderful subscribers and patrons. Don't forget, there's 20% off a monthly subscription box at theretro.co.uk. You need to go to the vinyl monthly subscription box there and put Jimmy Barnes, all one word, spelt with uppercase, lowercase mixture. I don't think it makes any difference. Go and check out with that. You will get 20% off the entire subscription, and it comes with a personal recommendation. I really enjoyed my box, and hopefully you'll be seeing my second sub box from the Retro later on this month. I'm going to go now, and I've already listened to Ricky and Celine. That was a pleasant, if somewhat cheesy, evening I had last night. I'm going to go and, in a bit, listen to Melanie C, which I've got a feeling will be my favourite of these three. And I do hope that all of you will join me again next time for my next mini disc collecting video. Cheers, everyone. See ya!